بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ومولاي يا رسول الله صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ومولاي يا أبا عبد الله يا رحمة الله الواسعة ويا باب نجاة الأمة غريب يا مظلوم كربلاء يا ليتنا كنا معكم سيدي فنفوز فوزا عظيما لعن الله الظالمين لكم من الأولين والآخرين وألحقهم بدرك الجحيم قال الله سبحانه وتعالى ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب صدق الله العلي العظيم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد الله سبحانه وتعالى mentions that whoever takes the signs of Allah as great, it is sign of piety of the hearts. Well, we know the name of Imam Hussain alayhi salam, who stood to establish justice in the Muslim society against tyranny of Umayyad rulers, is one of the best support for signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if one study the historical facts, you see that throughout the 14th century, from that time till today, the governments and rulers and caliphs, Umayyads, Abbasids, Ottoman and others, all were against the sha'air of Imam Hussein and remembering Imam Hussein, visiting Imam Hussein, crying for Imam Hussein and so on, you know, throughout the history. But still that name is there, and name of Imam Hussein is increasing day by day and is expanding day by day. It is mentioned that when they wanted to take the Sayyida Zainab Salamullah alayha and Imam Zainul Abidin from Karbala to Kufa, because they had cruel heart, they asked the army to take the family and children over the dead bodies, to see the dead bodies again, in order to burn their heart. Imam Zain al-Abidin salamullah alayh was affected too much by seeing the dead bodies of the Imam appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyid Shabab Ahl al-Jannah, master of the youth of paradise, grandson of the Prophet, and his brothers and cousins and nephews and family and companions all slaughtered and beheaded on the land of Karbala. So he was affected too much that Sayyida Zainab Salamullah alayha noticed that he might die because of that sorrow and effect. So she told him that, oh my nephew, don't worry about that. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make this as a monument, as a central place where people will come and visit from all over the places, and the enemies of Allah will try their best to remove that and demolish that and stop that, but it will not increase except by expansion and remains alive till end of the time. So they cannot do any harm, maybe temporarily, but by time there will be an expansion. Well, it is astonishing how brave was Sayyida Zainab Salamullah alayha to mention that fact by gut and say that this is going to happen in the future, and though we are now defeated, they killed all the men and we are captives, but still Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give us victory at the end. Of course, she said that is Ahdun Mahud. It is a covenant Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to his prophet, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned it to Amir al-Mu'mineen, to Fatima Zahra, and Sayyidah Zainab here that a promise, it is a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But she had that complete faith to discuss about this matter. And the same when she was in Kufa, she was discussing very bravely with Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, so much that he could not reply her, and he used the coward way of people by insulting the face of Imam Hussein and striking face of Imam Hussein with his stick, beating the lips of Imam Hussein in front of Sayyidah Zainab and others just to take revenge from them. And when they have gone to Sham, they suffered a lot in Sham. The traveling was not easy. It took about 20 days for a distance more than 1,000 kilometers, where family and children, and they without facilities, and you can imagine the needs for the children, for the women, and day, night, they used to be taken from place to place. Still, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a lot of things to remain till today as memory of that journey. We see in Mosul, the city in north of Iraq, before Mosul, there is a bath called Hammam al-Ali, the bath of Ali. Nowadays, they change Ali into Alil. Alil means the sick. So the water there is used for the treatment of many people who are sick, especially those who have skin diseases. They go there and take a bath, and they are treated. And it is mentioned that that road, when Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam passed, and that name is Hammam al-Ali, in name of Ali ibn al-Hussein. There is a mosque in Mosul, and Mosul is basically a Sunni area, not a Shia area. But still a mosque called Dawsat Ali. Dawsat means the pressure. When you press by your feet, say Dawsat. And in that mosque, there is a piece of a stone. There is a sign of 2 feet on the stone. And they said this is the sign of the feet of Ali. When he passed here, he was praying on the stone, and the stone became smooth, and now the sign of his feet is shown. So it looks that it was Ali ibn al-Hussein, not Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, because the way for Safin probably was a different way. And still till today in Mosul, there is a graveyard when the people of Mosul used to go there and take the clay and the dust from that graveyard. If they have any patient, they give it to him and he get healthy. It's called Qabr Banat Sayyidina al-Hassan, they call it. This is the graveyard of daughters of Imam Hassan alayhi salam. And it looks that some of the young daughters of Imam Hassan alayhi salam who were with the caravan, you know, those girls died and they were buried in Mosul. Until today, their graveyard is there, and the people have that faith. When they got sick, they go and take some of the clay from there, and by using it, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them health by the blessings of daughters of Imam Hassan alayhi salam. Well, the same thing, Mashhad al-Nuqta, it is in between Lebanon and Syria of today. There is a place of mosque. When head of Imam Hussein was on the spears, a drop of blood was on the stone, and then they built a place. Till today is existing. They call it Mashhad al-Nuqta. Nuqta means a drop, which means a drop of blood. at that time it happened. And even the burial place of Sayyida Zainab Salamullahi Alayha today is in Sham, and it is very known and big grave. The people from all over the world go to pay pilgrimage and visit for that holy shrine. The same thing, the place for Sayyida Ruqayya Salamullahi Alayha, who was a child and died, and she has a well-known grave near the Umayyad's mosque in Sham. So all this is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to keep this memory of Imam Hussein and whatever related to Imam Hussein alive all this time. In spite of the governments where Bani Umayyah were enemies of Ahlul Bayt, they used to kill the descendants of the Prophet, to kill the Shias, but still these memories remain till today. After them, Abbasids came, they had the same attitude, and the Abbasid government was about 500 years, and still the name of Ahlul Bayt remained. At the time of the Mutawakkil al-Abbasi, he was dead enemy of Ahlul Bayt, and he ordered to destroy the dome of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, which was destroyed. Then he asked the cow to plough the earth, but the cow came and could not cross the grave, moving around the grave but not touching the grave. He said, okay, put the water and it will be drowned with water. The water came around the grave of Imam Hussein. Say Ha'ir al-Husseini, or Hara means it was like somebody is puzzled, you know. So the water was puzzled and was circulating the grave of Imam Hussein without covering it with water. And he was dead enemy of the Shias who goes to visit Imam Hussein alayhi salam, that he asked everyone who goes will give 10 golden dinar, you know, which was a big money. Still the people used to give money and go for ziyarat of Imam Hussein. Then ultimately said he, I will cut right hands of everybody who go for ziyarat of Imam Hussein. The Shias insisted to go for ziyarat, and they asked, okay, you cut my fingers, I will go and pay pilgrimage to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. He found even that is not effective. Then he said, I will kill 1 out of 10 who go for visit of Imam Hussein. Still the people insisting to go, even if one is sacrificed, but he said the name of Imam Hussein should remain alive, you know, because that is the name of justice which condemn the cruel attitude of the governors and what they call caliphs and rulers of Umayyads and Abbasids and all the tyrant rulers till today. It is mentioned in the history that one of the police of Abbasids were hurting the visitors of Imam Hussein, sometimes, you know, take their luggage or beating them, while they try to do whatever harm to them. And one day he was tired and was sleeping when a caravan crossed. He saw that it looks like now the day in the dream. It was a dreaming. It is the day of judgment. And in the day of judgment, they asked him to go to hellfire because he was enemy of Ahlul Bayt. And he found that he goes to hellfire, but the hellfire goes away of him. And the angels were astonished why hellfire is not taking him, not burning him. The answer came because over his body is the dust of the visitors of Imam Hussein. Maybe he was by heart a good man or of a good root. He did not understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to guide him to the right path, and that is why he saw that dream. So when he was awake, well, he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and recited a poetry, إِذَا شِئْتَ النَّجَاةَ فَزُرْ حُسَيْنًا لكي تلقى الإله قرير عيني فإن النار ليس تمس جسما عليه غبار زوار الحسيني. If you want to be saved, go and visit Imam Hussein in order to meet Almighty Allah in the Day of Judgment in a happy situation, because the hellfire will not touch anybody which is covered by the dust of the visitors of Imam Hussein. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show to the people the greatness of visiting Imam Hussein, and that is why they continue till today. We see even in the last days, a time of the dictator of Iraq, for 40 years, you know, they tried to ban visit of Imam Hussein, but still the people were insisting to go. They sacrificed a lot, and they fought with the government. A lot of them were put in jail, a lot of them were killed, but still the people insisting for that. And when the dictator of Iraq was removed in 2003, now we see the visitors of Imam Hussein are in millions, you know. Maybe 50 years ago, there were 5,000, 10,000 persons in Arba'in to go to Karbala. Now it is in millions. Some statistics say 15, 20 millions, or maybe more. And they come from all over the world, in spite of lack of services, electricity and other security and other services. But still the people insist to go and visit the holy shrine of Imam Hussein. So this cannot be explained except that Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want this name to remain alive, you know. Otherwise, in a normal way, such graves will not be remembered by anyone, will be forgotten completely. Well, it is astonishing that the graves of the caliphs of Umayyad ruler, Umayyad caliphate, and Abbasids are not known. Where they were called as a caliph of the Muslims, he ruled half the world at that time, but they have no graves, no sign of them remained. While the graves of Ahlul Bayt salamullah alayhim everywhere is there, and the people till today they go and pay pilgrimage to them. Sayyida Zainab salamullah alayha, when she reached Sham, she had that discussion also with Yazeed. Yazeed was happy and joyous that he killed Imam Hussein and get rid of him, and now he is the ruler, he is the king, the dictator ruling the Muslim Ummah in spite of all his corruption and mischief he is doing, but still the people accepted him by whatever means, you know. Then Sayyida Zainab Salamullah Alayha, in her sermon, they told him that, do you think that you, when you have taken the roads of the land and ways of the heaven, and we are ultimately killed, is it because you are accepted and liked by Allah, and Allah do not like us? Haven't you read the Holy Quran? وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ. Those who are disbelievers should not think that if we allow them to live in this world, it is because a favor for them, but we allow them to live so that they are more sinful, and there is a punishment for them in the Day of Judgment. He mentioned that at the beginning to remove that misunderstanding that because he is victorious, then he is liked by Allah. No, it is not a rule. On the contrary, throughout the history, the prophets were tortured, killed by their people, and they were not successful materially, you know, because their aim is to deliver the message of God and let the people willingly to decide either to be a believer or not. It is not to use miracle to kill the people, except in certain situations like Prophet Noah, when Allah had drowned the non-believers at that time, you know. That is an exception in that way happen. Or Prophet Moses, after so many years of struggle with Pharaoh, and Pharaoh tried to kill them, then Allah saved them, and Pharaoh with his army were drowned, you know. So these are certain situations, you know. Otherwise, usually the things used to go in a natural way. So Sayyida Zainab salamullahi alayha told Yazeed about that, and then she told him, Fakid kaydak was'a sa'yak wa nasib juhdak fa Allah la tamhu dhikrana wa la tumit aw lan tumit wahyana. You try your best and do whatever you want, but I swear by Allah that the revelation, our revelation means Ahlul Bayt, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the head of Ahlul Bayt, you know. So that revelation will not die, you know. And our affairs will not be forgotten. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it alive, you know. And we see it remained alive till today, that the number of the believers is increasing day by day all over the world. And now we see the processions to remember Imam Hussein in all over the countries of the world, in Africa, in America, in Europe, India, Pakistan, and even in Japan, in Australia, all over the world. Now the people remember Imam Hussein alayhi salam. That is naturally the will of Allah that this name should remain alive. Well, about the burial on the day, 13th day, Imam Zain al-Abidin was in Kufa with Sayyida Zainab. They were in a place like a prison. And suddenly Sayyida Zainab found that Imam Zain al-Abidin is not there, you know. She was worried, where has he gone? But it looks it was the will of Allah that Imam Hussein should be buried by his son, by an imam. The imam cannot be buried except with another imam. So Imam Zain al-Abidin, by miracle, came from Kufa to Karbala. Banu Asad were there. There were a tribe around Karbala. Their ladies used to come and see these dead bodies and ask the men to come and bury them. Well, at the beginning they said, well, we are afraid from Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad. He has an army. They will kill us. And we cannot do that, you know. Till the third day, you know, the ladies of Banu Asad told their men that if you are not going to bury them, we, the women, are going to bury them. They said, okay, now we'll go and bury, because now the army is in Kufa, nobody is here. And they were around the dead bodies, but they don't know who is Imam Hussein, who is Abu al-Fadl, because they were beheaded, body without head, and not known this is body of whom, and that is body of whom. If they bury, then what they write on the grave. At that time, they noticed somebody is coming from the side of Kufa. And they were very much in trouble and very excited that maybe he is a spy from Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad to see who bury these bodies. Then he came. When he came near, he asked them, what are you doing here? Well, they were afraid to say that we are going to bury. We said, okay, we are coming just to see what has happened here. He said, no, tell me the truth. Well, they found him. They don't know he is Imam Zain al-Abidin, but they found him a good man. They said, well, we found these bodies for 3 days are here, and we wanted to bury them, but we don't know but these bodies belong to whom. Then Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam told them that I will help you for that. Then he came and he wanted to carry the body Imam Hussein. It was cut into pieces. Whatever piece of his body is removed, you know, the other part will fall down, which was not possible to be carried because it was cut by the spears and swords into pieces. So he asked for mat to be brought, and then he put that body in the mat gradually, and then carried it to the grave, and then he himself put it in the grave. And when he came out, started crying and wrote on the grave, Hada Qabr al-Hussein ibn Ali. This is the grave of Hussein ibn Ali, who was killed in a thirsty situation. Then he buried Ali al-Asghar on the chest of Imam Hussein, and buried the companions around Imam Hussein, around the grave. And he buried Ali al-Akbar near the feet of Imam Hussein. And then when he finished there, He said, well, still there is another brave person, and that is near the river. And he came toward Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, salamullahi alayhi, and then buried him. When he wanted to return, the people came and he said, by Allah, we ask you, who are you? How do you know the names of these people? Then Imam told them, I am your Imam, Zain al-Abidin Ali ibn al-Hussein. When he returned back to Kufa, Sayyida Zainab was very much worried. He said, what happened, my nephew? You are not to be seen, and I was afraid something happened to you. He said, well, Amma, my aunt, I just came back after burial of my father. She said, till today, after 3 days, the body of Imam Hussein were not buried till now. He said, yes, that is what happened. Inna lillah wa inna alayhi raji'un. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين اللهم أنا نسألك وندعوك بجلال وجهك الكريم وقرآنك العظيم وبمحمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين أن تعجل فرج وليك صاحب العصر والزمان وأن تجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه ومن المجاهدين بين يديه اللهم املأ به الأرض قسطا وعدلا بعدما ملئت ظلما وجورا اللهم اقض به حوائجنا واشف بهم مرضانا وارحم بهم موتانا واغفر بهم ذنوبنا ووسع بهم أرزاقنا وبارك بهم لنا في ديننا ودنيانا وآخرتنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا اللهم لك الحمد أن مننت علينا بولاية محمد وآل محمد في الدنيا فارزقنا يوم القيامة شفاعتهم ومن حوض الكوثر شرابهم وعلى الصراط مرافقتهم وفي الجنة مجاورتهم في أعلى عليين مع الشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا وإلى روح موت الحاضرين وموت الباذلين والمؤسسين وشيعة أمير المؤمنين خصوصا من العلماء والشهداء وذوي الحقوق رحم الله من يهدي لهم جميعا ثواب الفاتحة قبلها صلوات اللهم صل على محمد الحمد لله